chronicles the life of someone fighting crime and wanting to change life. That's right, I'm talking about the star of what was A&E's Dog the Bounty Hunter and is now CMT's Dog and Beth on the Hunt, Dog Chapman. Welcome to the show, Dog. Thanks so much for coming on.
Oh, you're very welcome. Thank you for having me.
It is a pleasure to have you. Now, first, for those who aren't familiar with the move from A&E to CMT, what is the difference between Dog the Bounty Hunter, the show, and Dog and Beth on the Hunt?
Good question, and I'll try to answer that. Okay, so with A&E, we were hunting in just Hawaii, and once in a while we went to Colorado. And I was training my children to, you know, follow in their father's footsteps. With the new show, we had retired from A&E, and Electus, a production company, came to us and said, listen, I don't know if you've seen this, but there's a lot of people out there thinking they're Dog and Beth, and they're getting shot dead.
Wow.
They said, if we put you in a bus, kind of like a country western traveler, music traveler, would you like to go town to town? We have a lot of requests from different bail bondsmen across the United States that they'd like you to come help them. And, of course, Beth and I said, you know, we'll try it. So the first season was, you know, as a first season goes, you know, hit and miss. And all of a sudden, it just took off, and we're into our second season. The ratings are great. And, of course, I'm supposed to say I like the show better for advertising, but truthfully, I do like the show better because there's more personalities. You know, we have grandmas doing it. We have ex-NFL players doing it. We have women, team of five girls you do not want to run from doing it. I mean, it's incredible. We're having a ball.
So it's really encouraging people to want to step up, do the right thing, and almost kind of do what you guys have been doing for a number of years.
Well, people think you got to eat nails to be a bounty hunter, tough guy. I got a gun, I'm a dead-eye shot. So we're disarming our bounty hunters with non-lethal weapons. I mean, the weapons we give out will do exactly what a gun does, except for with a gun, you die. With these, you do not die. They're non-lethal. So, I think it's, the training that we're giving them has saved my life for 40 years. So a lot of, so far, 100% have adopted to our ways. And if you got to catch the guy. You know, the main thing is catch him. The second thing is not kill him and give him some kind of hope. But that first thing on catching the guy, you got to have a certain talent. You know, it kind of comes natural to me. So training these other bondsmen to catch him has been very successful.
Now, one thing I'm curious about, I mean, you've been in this for a number of years, but how did you first get started?
Well, that is a long story, but I started it when I was in jail in prison in Texas in the late 70s. I was in my early 20s, and I did 18 months in the Texas Department of Correction, and that's where it started.
So for you, it started pretty much on the other side as the same people who you're looking to catch, and then you just realized that justice needs to be taken care of.
Well, I was I saw that cops back in the 70s and law enforcement were mostly scum, and they beat everybody up, and they dogged them, and they told them, like, all those with mothers still alive, take one step forward. Not so fast, Mr. Smith. And they thought that was funny.
Wow.
And so I thought, you know what? I'm going to take that badge and polish it, and I'm going to show morality, and I'm going to show love, and I'm going to show toughness, and I'm going to show these guys that, you know, to have a badge and to be a cop or to be a person of authority, you don't have to be a scumbag. And so that's what motivated me mostly, was because the way the guards and the cops used to treat people back then. And I thought, that's not the way to do this. And I've tried to show them the right way, the biblical and anybody's Bible way, you know. So I think that was my secret to my success in the early days.
And one thing that people can definitely see to attest for that with the show from Dog the Bounty Hunter is that you guys do put care and you want to see these people changing.
Right, and the new show, Dog and Beth on the Hunt, we do the same. You know, we train the bail companies, the bounty hunters. They're now called bail enforcement agents. So we train them how to have compassion. And, you know, after you're done with the guy, there got to be, you're not a cop, you're an American citizen. You got to be something, you know, there's got to be something that you can do or say to help that person out. I mean, and you're responsible at that point right then for that person's life and maybe their soul. So you better do something to help. So we're training, in order to be a bail bondsman, there's that gift or that want to help ability spirit inside that person anyway. They don't just wake up and say, oh, I want to go get out Mary Poppins because she's in jail. You got to have that extra intestinal fortitude to be able to love people and help them when they're down and out. So you're already working with a group of people that have that kind of heart. So to train them in a way is a lot easier than you would be training, you know, let's say, in no offense, an ex-highway patrolman. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. And now, with the new show, you guys are getting ready to start a new season of Dog and Beth on the Hunt. So what can people expect to see specifically in the new season?
Well, we're going to a town near you. We're going across the United States. You know, everywhere there is a barber shop, it seems like there's a bail bonds company. So instead of seeing Beth and Dog and Leland, Baby Lisa, Dwayne Lee, all the kids all the time, you're going to be able to meet different personalities of different families in different settings, in different cities, different weather, different. You know what I mean? So it's not the same humdum Kardashians over and over and over and over. You're going to get to see other personalities on the show that could shine as bright as our star does.
Brynn, we got to go.
Okay, and that's awesome. Thanks so much for coming on the program, Dog. It's really been a pleasure talking with you, and I wish we had more time.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Just call my guy. We'll make more time.
All right, thanks. Bye.
Okay, bye-bye.
And that was Dog Chapman. He is the star of, well, the former star of A&E's Dog the Bounty Hunter. Now he's the star of CMT's Dog and Beth on the Hunt. You can catch new episodes on CMT every Saturday at 9 p.m.